Very good morning. Today it's students going to learn clauses. Let's start discussion. First we will explain the entire concept, we will discuss the entire concept, and after that we'll discuss with some examples. Okay, let's start. Here the introduction with some examples. Let's discuss. A group of words that form a sentence. A group of words that form a sentence and has a subject and a finite verb. Here you have to focus. Subject also and finite verb also. Subject bhi hota hai aur finite verb bhi hota hai. Is called clauses. A clause has only one finite verb. It's called clauses. One finite verb. Previously we discussed about phrase. Phrase is what here we discuss, but phrase has no finite verb. Means a phrase can be said a group of words that do not have any kind of verb. Means there is no action in this particular group of words. But here may be chances that there is a finite verb. There are chances, possibilities more. Example, Mr. Munshi is a man of great wealth. In the first sentence, we do not have any kind of verb. We do not have verb, but we have only noun. Both first and second. Second sentence says, Mr. Munshi is a man who owns a great wealth. Mr. Munshi is a man who owns a great wealth. Here same we have noun, but we don't want noun. We want subject and verb, because clause states that a group of words that contain subject and verb is considered as a clause. Let's see. We have who. This is our subject. Okay, it's one kind of says that it is a complex sentence. Mr. Munshi is a man who owns a great wealth. In a simple sentence, we can say Mr. Munshi is a man of great wealth. So, who is our subject and owns is a finite verb. Here we call owns our verb. Subject, verb, sentence is a clause. Now, distinguish between phrase, clause and sentence. So first, no verb cannot stand by on its own, cannot stand, does not explain anything, here do not contain any kind of meaning. A clause, one finite verb, means it contains one verb, may or may not stand on its own, chances. Sentence, at least one finite verb and definitely can stand on its own. Simple, read and write in your notebook now. Here, still I have to write something. Here we have three main parts of clause: connective, subject, finite verb. We will that sentence must contain connective words. Subject should be there, finite verb should be there. Like phrase, clause can also act as an adjective, adverb and noun. Adjective, adverb and noun. So according to this, we'll have three types of clause: noun, adjective and adverb. Got it? Here noun clause, little bit explanation. Next, in the next lecture we will discuss more about noun clause. Here we have noun clause is a group of word which has its own subject, okay, and dependent, it acts as a dependent clause. We'll meet in the next lecture.